don't remember if there's people here or not. Forgot, I don't activate things like that. All day? Good. Made that time. Which I should be looking for something for this. Probably blind and just can't see it. It's normally the case. Out. Many thanks. Take that, that's what I need. Dwarven chest. You just have crap in it. This right here. It's an expert. Nope. So close! Come on. I want that sword. It's... That sword's a good sword, so... Thank you. That should be children. It is. And now it's mine. My way. Just...
Oh.
Really, Lydia. Let me try this. There isn't one. Sorry. Catch up with me, Lydia? She gets hit by that. Keep crawling. Never gonna make it past that. Let's go. Come on, Lydia, stop playing around. The stairs. Just I'm blind apparently. Let's go. I need candlelight so bad in here now. Okay, candlelight with something, it's something now required for me to have, because simply you can't see anything. At all. Especially in the dark. It's going to be something very useful to have. So, candlelight, something that's now required. Instead of just shooting flames everywhere. You're going to load. Thank you. I think I actually had a level up, so I did. I'm actually going to level up my health some. Able to get that. What do I need for that? That's a level 70. I don't really care about that one. I just... I still can't leave through that way. Let's go back to the Thieves Guild. And push the button. Really very short quest. I'm mainly only doing these to get the skeleton key, then I'm going to hoard off on the skeleton key and hold it until my lockpicking's at level 100, and then from there I shall continue onwards.
I can't believe he emptied the bomb right from under our noses.
I can.
We've scoured the town and I've spoken to every contact we have left. No sign of Mercer. Any luck on your end?
Yes.
Shor's beard. He's going after the eyes of the Falmer? That was Gallus's pet project. If he gets his hands on them, you can be certain he'll be gone for good and set up for life. Agreed. He's taken everything the guild has left, and to go after one of the last greatest heists is just an insult. I've spoken to Carlaya and made amends for how the guild's treated her. Now she wishes to speak with both of us. Quickly, we have no time to lose. Till next we meet, lass.
Start it. Listen to Carlisle. I can do this.
Not now, lass. Carlisle said it was...
Brynjolf, the time has come to decide Mercer's fate. Until a new guildmaster is chosen, the decision falls to you.
Aye, lass. And I've come to a decision.
Mercer Frey tried to kill both of you. He betrayed the guild, murdered Gallus, and made us question our future. He needs to die.
We have to be very careful, Brynjolf. Mercer is a nightingale, an agent of Nocturnal.
It's all true. Everything I heard in the stories. The Nightingales, their allegiance to Nocturnal, and the Twilight Sepulchre.
Yes. That's why we need to prepare ourselves and meet Mercer on equal footing. Just outside of Riften, beyond the southeast gate, is a small path cut up the mountainside. At the end of that path is a clearing, and an old standing stone. I'd ask you both to meet me there.
Okay, I will do so.
I have some preparations of my own. I'll meet you at the stone.
Let's go to the stone, because I can. I please leave. Thank you. I want to see my waypoint. Right there. The Shatterstone. I've already been here, so that's great. It's really, really great. Perfect. We already killed this guy. Over here, I guess.
I'm glad you're here. This is the headquarters of the Nightingales, cut into the mountainside by the first of our kind. We've come to seek the edge we need to defeat Mercer Frey.
Well, we'll go for him,
so. If you'll follow me, I'll try to explain on the way. This way, please.
A door there. Like I said, I can't see anything right now, so.
So this is Nightingale Hall. I heard about this place when I joined the guild, but I never believed it existed.
The assumption that the Nightingale was just a myth was seeded within the guild on purpose. It helped divert attention from our true nature. What's wrong, Brynjolf? I can almost hear your brow furrowing.
I'm trying to understand why I'm here, lass. I'm no priest. I'm certainly not religious. Why pick me?
This isn't about religion, Rudolf. It's business. This is Nightingale Hall. You're the first of the uninitiated to set foot in.
I've never seen anything quite like that.
No. If you'll both proceed to the armory to don your Nightingale armor, we can begin the oath.
Time's wasting, and Mercer's still out there. This show on the road.
You appear hesitant to don your Nightingale armor. That's true.
Let's go get armor. Yay. I now have the armor I like. Guess that doesn't automatically equip it like I thought it did. It's right here.
I
want to know if there's a cape that a mod that fixes capes.
Time's wasting, and Mercer's still out there. Let's get this show on the road.
Oh, yeah, we'll just continue walking.
You appear ready for the oath.
This is enough to make your head spin, eh?
Not really. Lots of new weapons here. I'm still gonna, of course, gonna stick to my sword most of anything. So. Novice. Nice looking sword, too. Anyway, what I'm looking for, anyway, is an ebony sword. I don't really care about anything else.
You appear ready for the
okay, lass. We've got these get-ups on. Now what?
Beyond this gate is the first step in becoming a Nightingale.
Whoa there, lass. I appreciate the armor, but becoming a Nightingale? That was never discussed.
To hold any hope of defeating Mercer, we must have Nocturnal at our backs. If she's to accept you as one of her own, an arrangement must be struck.
What sort of arrangement? I need to know the terms.
Terms are quite simple, Brynjolf. Nocturnal will allow you to become a Nightingale and use your abilities for whatever you wish. And in return, both in life and in death, you must serve as a guardian of the Twilight Sepulchre.
Aye, there's always a catch. But at this point, I suppose there isn't much to lose. If it means the end of Mercer Frey, you can count me in.
What about you? Are you ready to transact the oath with Nocturnal?
Oh, yeah.
Good. After I open the gate, please stand on the Western Circle.
This is enough to make Bene.
Can't use this right now? What?
We'll speak when the oath is complete.
I think we should trust the lass and take the deal.
And the Western Gate.
I call upon you, Lady Nocturnal, Queen of Mirth,
10 o'clock,
and Empress of Shadow. Hear my voice.
Ah, Carlyle. I was wondering when I'd hear from you again. Lose something, did we?
My lady, I've come before you to throw myself upon your mercy and to accept responsibility for my failure.
You're already mine, Carlyle. Your terms were struck long ago. What could you possibly offer me now?
I have two others that wish to transact the oath. To serve you both in life and in death.
You surprise me, Carlyle. This offer is definitely weighted in my favor.
My appetite for Mercer's demise exceeds my craving for wealth, Your Grace.
Revenge. How interesting. Very well. The conditions are acceptable. You may proceed.
Lady Nocturne. Accept your terms. We dedicate ourselves to you as both your avengers and your sentinels. We will honor our agreement in this life and the next until your conditions have been met.
Very well. I name your initiates Nightingale, and I restore your status to the same, Carlyle. And in the future, I'd suggest you refrain from disappointing me again.
Transacted the oath. It's time to reveal the final piece of the puzzle to you. Mercer's true crime. Mercer was able to unlock the Guild's vault without two keys because of what he stole from the Twilight Sepulchre. The skeleton key. By doing this, he's compromised our ties to Nocturnal and, in essence, caused our luck to run dry. Well, yes. But the key isn't only restricted to physical barriers. All of us possess untapped abilities, the potential to wield great power securely sealed within our minds. Once you realize the key can access these traits, potential becomes limitless. Although it would benefit the Guild more than you can imagine, in the end it would do more harm than good. If the key isn't returned to its lock in the Twilight Sepulchre, things will never be the same for the Guild. As time passed, our luck would diminish to the point of non-existence. And whether you know it or not, our uncanny luck defines our trade.
I'm gonna stop talking.
True. In our... Before we depart, Brynjolf has some business to discuss. I suggest you listen to him.
Listen, lass. There's one last piece of business we need to settle before we go after Mercer. The leadership of the Guild. Carlyle and I had a long discussion before you arrived here.
Thanks to your efforts.
As a result, we both feel that you have the... I've been at this game a long time, my friend. A long time. I've stolen trinkets from nobles. I'm good at what... I've never been one to lead. Never desired it, never cared for it. Don't want it. Well, we have a bit of an errand to run before... Then it's decided. Until then, we have... I've been part of... Carlyle and I will meet you there. Prepare yourself, lass.
Okay.
This will be a fight to remember.
Okay. Let's go get the skeleton key, because that's what I want. So right now, I'm not bringing it back right away. I'm going to level up my lockpicking. Ah. until it's level 100, and then I have the perk for unbreakable lockpicks. Then I shall carry one lockpick with me at all times, because you know they don't break anymore. Might as well. It's only once I get that perk, but that's a level 100 perk, so there's no real good way to actually do this without having to hold it for hours. Just really long time. Let's go and let's go get things. I know there was a little bit of lag because it did, you know, autosave stuff. Which side of the mountain is that on? It's on the far side of the mountain. Meaning, I could go to Snowvale Sanctum. Let's go here. Let's go this and follow the river. I've been there, and I haven't discovered Windhelm, so let's go and discover Windhelm. If I have not discovered it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Thank you. Drop down to 3 frames. I am looking. So I need to go this way. Should be about where I need to go. No. I need to go this way. That looks like the keep. Should be the keep. Looking at that water. Waterfalls is still kind of bad. Talk to Blake about that, see if there's something I could do to possibly make that better. Still really bad meshes, and I have some kind of mesh patch. I swear I do. I think I do. I don't remember. Did I get a mesh? Dang. Actually, I don't see one on there. I thought I did. Windhelm Stables. Let's go and discover Windhelm. In fact, let's go look inside of it. Is that a dried up lake bed? Can't really tell. Also, like this way. Kinda pretty. Wonder if it's got that nice flickering effect. Now when it gets way off, it just kinda turns white. We've got lines again. I don't know what causes those lines. I figured I would have that, figured those would end up being fixed. So those lines are shadows. They're caused by shadows. I know that. Figure that out. That door looks a lot better. Hey, that's a nice looking armor. That looks like ebony, actually. No, that's Blade's armor. Why am I thinking?
You eat our food, you pollute our city with your stink, and you refuse to help the Stormcloaks.
But we haven't taken a side because it's not our fight.
Hey, maybe the reason these Greyskins don't help in the war is because they're Imperial spies.
Imperial spies? You can't be serious.
Maybe we'll pay you a visit tonight, little spy. We got ways of finding out what you really are.
Oh. Do you hate the Dark Elves? Are you here to bully us and tell us to leave?
I'm a Dark Elf, you're a vampire.
You've come to the wrong city, then. Windhelm's a haven of prejudice and narrow thinking, unworthy of one such as you. Nothing new there. He likes to get drunk and walk around the Greykwater yelling insults at us in the some of these And it isn't just... In fact, just about anyone who isn't a Nord is fair game for their bullying. Safe travels.
Let's go and discover this over here.